We talk about a lot of things that we want to see happen on Monday night. New characters, new storylines, Kane to put his mask back on, the return of the Attitude Era. But there was one thing that happened last night that needed to happen. Let's talk about it. This is Raw Graded. Miz TV opens up. Miz and Morrison tell us that tonight the main event is a six-man tag. They are teaming with Randy Orton against Drew McIntyre and The New Day. Miz teases he might even cash in on Randy Orton tonight. And as he's talking about the return of Miz and Mrs., his TV show, this brings out Randy Orton, and Orton eviscerates them. Just kicking off about how Miz is talking about his TV show. Calls out John Morrison for taking his ball and going home to work in the minor leagues. Talking about how Miz got booted out of the locker room years ago and he wishes he'd never let him back in. Randy Orton even offers Miz a free shot to take him out and try and win the WWE title. As they bicker, the New Day come out and call out their verbal strong style. A lot of back and forth here. As they get into the ring, Orton jumps. And then Drew comes out to even the odds, but he ends up eating an RKO in the process. We'll see everybody later on for the main event. It's an A- to open the show. I thought Orton was on great form here. When Orton is motivated, he's excellent. And I just enjoyed the destruction of Miz and Morrison on the mic here. And I like the tease that he's teaming with the Money in the Bank winner, who might have a little go. They've certainly planted a little seed going into that story, going into that match later on today. Our opening match is a triple threat. It's Elias versus Jeff Hardy versus Riddle. AJ Styles and Big Jordan watching this match backstage as the final member of the Raw Survivor Series team is going to be determined tonight. Elias expects to be interrupted and realizes he's not being interrupted, starts playing, then gets interrupted. Fun little fake out there. When we get underway, everybody gets a turn at taking the lead in this one. Really good television match between all three of these guys. The end of which comes when we see Jeff go for a twist of fate and Elias hits that big running knee to take out Jeff. Shortly after this, we see Elias fall prey to the bro Derek for the 1-2-3. Elias wins the match. Backstage, we see Adam Pearce and AJ having a little chat about something. And then we find out that AJ is indeed going to welcome Riddle with open arms into the Survivor Series team. This upsets Sheamus and Braun Strowman, who neither want Riddle on the team nor want to call AJ captain. More on that later. This was a B+. This was a really good TV match here. I thought they put some good stuff together. I thought, obviously, there was an element of it was quite tame. But I think when we see what plays out a bit later on, that might explain a little bit of that. But it was very good. And this is one of the good things that's come from the draft, is that this feels like a fresh encounter. This feels like something that's fresh from Monday night, so I'm not against it. Mustafa Ali and Retribution promise destruction backstage. Mustafa Ali facing Ricochet later on. And Reckoning, Mia Yim, has some choice words for Asuka, teasing something with them a little bit down the line. Drew Gulak approaches the Hurt Business after this. He's wearing a lovely red suit jacket and a clip-on tie, and he wants to be a part of the Hurt Business. They politely decline, then actively destroy him, leaving him laying on the floor. Enter R-Truth, gets the pin. R-Truth is 24/7 champion once again. Shenanigans. Lana reluctantly makes her way to the ring for the next match. She is taking on Shayna Baszler. We've got Dandy, Dana Brooke, and Mandy Rose ringside at the commentation station for this one. Baszler gets jumped by Lana from the off, but that's pretty much all the offense that Lana gets here. Baszler pretty quickly takes her out. Big kicks, drops her, clutch, tap out, done. After which we see Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler look like they're gonna put Lana through the table, but Dandy actually stops them doing it, stands in the way, and they end up leaving. Backstage, Lana thanks Dana Brooke and Mandy Rose, but they're upset that Lana seemingly cost them the women's tag titles last week and tells her to stay out of the way. Giving this a C+, not much to write about in-ring, but some storyline development here. I genuinely think I'm turning a corner on the Lana thing. I think they've got me. I think they've got me. Genuinely feel really sympathetic for Lana, who seems to have no friends in the world right now and is constantly getting beaten up. And if this lost soul becomes the sole survivor at Survivor Series, I shan't be surprised. AJ Styles leads a meeting of the Raw Survivor Series team in the ring. Keith Lee, Braun Strowman and Sheamus, all very cross following the fighting from last week. But Riddle, the newest team member, is trying to cool things down. He assigns everybody a code name for Survivor Series. AJ is Skipper. We see Braun Strowman is Mongoose. Keith Lee is Broly and Sheamus is Fireface. Sheamus then calls Riddle Doping. They're all better names than Retribution, I'm just saying. This seems to help the mood for a little bit, but then AJ reveals that he's organised a tag team match to help get a little bit of the tension out of the team. It's gonna be Keith Lee teaming with Riddle to take on Braun Strowman and Sheamus, or rather it should be Dopey and Broly taking on Mongoose and Fireface with Skipper as the guest referee. Pretty standard tag team affair here, very serviceable match. AJ seemingly calling it down the middle. He accidentally gets hit by Riddle. He accidentally gets squashed by Braun and Lee. This brings Big Jordan into the ring, his mammoth bodyguard. Looks like he's gonna get involved. Yet when we cut back from break, he's back outside. Weird thing to tease, that one. The teams just can't get along. We see Keith Lee going wild on everybody and even uses Riddle to powerbomb onto Braun Strowman, which is a peculiar move. I thought they were mates. Sheamus and Strowman can't get along. They keep tagging themselves in the match. Eventually, Sheamus has enough. Bro kicks Strowman off of the apron. Riddle gets the roll up and gets the win for his team. Giving this whole thing a B. I love the town hall segment with those guys at the very beginning. And it was a serviceable tag team match. For me, the highlight was the promo at the beginning, giving everybody code names. I like the dichotomy of this Survivor Series team now that we've got Riddle in there, sort of to ease some of the tension of these beasts that dominate the landscape. Nikki and Firefly Funhouse Alexa Bliss meet up backstage. Nikki is sorry for not being there for Alexa when the Fiend attacked her, but she's there now and she wants Alexa to make a decision, but Bliss is away with the fairies here. She seems just to be happy, smiley, playing with rose petals, and she eventually says that she has to choose. She chooses him, referring to Bray Wyatt and the Fiend, and she walks off. So I guess that kind of draws a line officially under Nikki and Alexa Bliss now. No Bray Wyatt or Fiend this week. He was missing, but I don't think he was missed. I like the fact that he's on Raw. I like the character. I think it was nice to have a fallow week of the Fiend and Bray Wyatt. Alexa Bliss being there keeps him in our hearts and minds, but keeps him away from television. Bobby Lashley is out with MVP, her business promising victory over the New Day next week. They're challenging for the Raw Tag Team titles, by the way. And promising victory at Survivor Series. Lashley is gonna beat Sami Zayn into a fine powder or something like that. This brings out Titus O'Neil, who says that if Bobby Lashley wants to be the US champion, why hasn't he defended the US championship? MVP says he respects Titus' charity work, gives him chance to leave. Titus ain't leaving. Lashley don't respect him. So they say, hey, look, if you want a title shot, let's have one right now. Just before the match starts, MVP gets on the mic and says, remember, Titus, this match is happening above the ring, not below it. We all remember Titus World Slide, don't we? This distracts Titus. Lashley gets the jump. We get a couple of strikes from Titus, but moments into this match, feels like we see Lashley peel out a spear and then apply the Hurt Lock for the tap out win. C+, it was a showcase for Bobby Lashley just to keep him ticking over until Survivor Series. I thought Titus was good on the mic here. I would say good showing, but he got battered. But he was good on the mic. Drew McIntyre and Sheamus are backstage. Sheamus is still pushing this idea of him and Drew teaming together again like the good old days. And Drew is doing that really polite friend thing where he's like, hey, you never know what'll happen, but hey, let's go for beers when I win the championship back. Let's do that. Yeah, yeah, fist bumps. Let's do that. I'm very intrigued where this is going. Like, Sheamus seems to be pushing to get the band back together. And Drew's a bit like, Yeah, I suppose, you know, I like that. Whether we end up with a Drew Sheamus program before the year is out, I guess we will see. Asuka takes on Nia Jax next. Dandy and Lana are ringside for this one, as is Shayna Baszler. We see Asuka start to wear down Nia early on with an octopus stretch and an armbar, but Jax ends up taking over by throwing her into the barricade to break the armbar. After the break, Jax is in control. Bit of a flurry from Asuka, gets the wind knocked out of her, but one more flurry of of back fists and kicks, starts to see the tide once again a turning. Baszler gets onto the apron. Lana jumps onto the apron to alert the referee, and she gets the clutch from Baszler for her trouble. Asuka ends up hip attacking Lana off the apron, then going in for the kill on Nia Jax, countering a Samoan drop with the Asuka lock. This brings in Shayna Baszler, breaks it up, and the DQ is called. Dandy jump into the ring after this. They get beaten up, and then it leaves Lana alone in the ring, who lo and behold gets a Samoan drop, buff, through the announce table, as is one to do. Giving this one a B, I thought that Asuka and Jax have had better matches in the past. I don't feel like this was their best work, but it really just served as a means to get Lana through an announce table. That's the whole reason I think this was here. R-Truth finds out he's in a 7-way for the 24/7 championship next. He thought it was a photo shoot. Oh, R-Truth. Yes, silly Billy. So it's R-Truth. And the funny thing is, and this is how predictable the 24/7 division has become, I started writing down the competitors before the match had even started. So it was R-Truth, Akira Tozawa, we had Drew Gulak in there, Lindsay Dorado, Gran Metalik, but then they chucked in Eric and Tucker. Look at that. Straight off the bat, we see Akira Tozawa get the pin and become the 24/7 champion. So it goes, Tozawa wins it, Eric wins it, Gulak wins it, Tucker wins it, Drew wins it, Tucker wins it, Metalik pins Tucker, Dorado pins Metalik, then Truth lands an FU, wins it back and runs away. That's the match. C+. It was entertaining for the amount of pinfalls there were. Still think the 24/7 division is getting horrendously repetitive, but this was pretty entertaining. Also, who'd have called it? Last week, we were saying that Tucker is done and dusted in WWE. We were saying this is the beginning of the burial of Tucker. Tucker won his first singles championship in WWE before Otis, not counting Money in the Bank. Not counting that, he's beaten Otis to his first singles belt. And he did it twice. So well done, Tucker. You trooper, you. Mustafa Ali taking on Ricochet now. During the match, Ali invites Ricochet to join Retribution. Ricochet's not having any of it. This starts off as a slow-building argument within a wrestling match, with Ali running down Ricochet and talking about how he has to be a part of what they're doing. Ricochet wants nothing to do with it. We see a beauty of a head scissor takedown off the apron onto Ali just before the break. When we come back from the break, though, Mustafa Ali is back in charge. Ricochet deadlifts Ali off a tornado DDT to get back into this, using it into turning it into a Northern Lights suplex, which looked beautiful. We then see Ali pull out a backstabber off the top rope for a near fall. That looks stunning. Ricochet pushing back into this one. He wipes out Retribution with a spinning dive to the outside of the ring, but goes for that twisting senton in the ring, but Ali's had time to recover, so he dodges it, and then applies a submission hold to get the tap out win on Ricochet. Clean as a whistle, Ali has defeated Ricochet. This match to me was an A-. I thought this was the best wrestling match of the night for me. Started a bit slow, but when they got going, they had a great time with it. And this is what Retribution needed. They needed not just a win, they needed a solid defining win. And Ali beating Ricochet clean via submission just puts them back in control. Lots of good stuff happened with Retribution tonight. We had Reckoning throwing out some shade towards the Raw Women's Champion, and we had Ali winning clean as a whistle over Ricochet. Like, these are good things. I don't think Ricochet is hurt by this loss. He's in there with Retribution. I think there'll be more of the story to be told there. It was a very competitive match. Excellent work by both. They're always going to be top class. Best match of the night. Adam Pearce informs Randy Orton that he is going to be defending his WWE title next week against Drew McIntyre. Orton throws Pearce up against the wall, not very happy about that situation, but he's got to get his head in the game because he's about to walk out to the ring for the main event. It's a 6-man tag, Orton teaming with Miz and Morrison to face the New Day and Drew McIntyre. New Day hit dives early on to take the advantage, but after the break, Miz and Morrison are in the lead. Orton is really despondent throughout this match. We've got Drew on the one side, goading Orton to get amongst it, and Orton, it just keeps dropping off the ring apron and walking round. He just doesn't want to get in there. At one point, Miz offers him a tag and Orton's just not taking it. Like, Orton clearly, like, his head is thinking about next week, which is a nice little storyline element in there. Drew gets a hot tag, and he is a house of fire. He wipes out everybody. Double overhead suplex to Miz and Morrison. He hits the future shock on Morrison, and then throws Morrison into Orton's corner. Tells him to tag in and give people a preview of next week. Orton goes to, then changes his mind, and heads off up the ramp. And then there's a schmoz from everybody that ends with Drew landing a Glasgow kiss as Morrison dives towards him, and then hitting that claymore, pinning him while staring down Randy Orton for the three. Next week, Drew and Orton go once again. And I'm giving the main event a B+. Enjoyed this a lot. I like some of the storytelling elements in it. It wasn't the most exciting of matches in ring, but the elements to watch was Orton on the ringside area and Drew just getting fiery on the other side there as well. Everybody played their parts really well. See you next week for a title match. And overall this week, I'm giving Raw a B. This felt like a pretty good episode of Monday Night Raw, actually. Some nice things that were moving forward. Some nice new matches set up as well. And you know what? I'm ready to see Drew and Orton again next week. I know I've complained about them having the same match over and over again, and I'm ready for a mix-up. I can't help but feel Drew's winning next week. I'm thinking about this. I think Drew's winning next week because the last time they did something like this, it was Survivor Series a few years ago, and it was meant to be AJ versus Brock, champion versus champion. And Daniel Bryan pipped him at the post. I think it was the last SmackDown before Survivor Series. Daniel Bryan became WWE champion. I wonder whether they're going to give us the old switcheroo here. I must be honest, I'm more invested. If we're talking about building to Survivor Series, I'm more intrigued by Drew McIntyre versus Roman Reigns than Roman Reigns versus Randy Orton. Whether or not they're saving Drew and Roman for another time, I don't know. I'd be fine with that if they are, but I'm certainly more invested in that than the other. I'm just saying. But good episode of Raw this week. There's lots to love. Stay safe. Love you, bye.